welcome to this episode of Cryptido. In the previous episode, I was talking about working out, and it was actually, I think, a live episode that we did. One of the questions was, why don't I wrap my hands? And I answered was because you don't have the chance to wrap them in a street situation. Well, I injured my hand at a demonstration back in October, and talking to one of my instructors the other day, she recommended that since I use my hand so much in everyday life with the wheelchair and plus with training with the martial arts, that it would be recommended that I did wrap my hands. You have hand wraps. You can buy these at sporting goods store. Some have a loop right here for your thumb. And you want to wrap the mostly around where you need the protection. Some like it around the wrist because they like wrist protection. I have strong wrists because of pushing my wheelchair and walking on the crutches. So I need it more on the knuckle because that's where I got injured. So, and every once in a while you want to make a fist because you don't want it to get too tight. And we're at the end, and then you wrap it around. Some of them have Velcro. These ones do. You're all set. And you get your glove that you're going to be using to work out with. This also gives you extra support around your wrist with that wrap, and you're good to go. That's how you wrap your hands for working out. Next, we're going to talk about wheelchair defense, using your wheelchair as a weapon. People say, you know, what would you do? Well, me, somebody comes up to me, starts some trouble. First, you try to defuse the situation verbally, talk your way out of it. You don't want to get into a physical confrontation if you don't have to. Like I said previously, your hands are strong. You push a wheelchair, you walk on crutches. You can get a hold of them. This is what you got here for. This can be used as strike, elbow. Go like this, or you're going to strike them with both, like that. You can also block with it. If they're coming down with something like that, you can grab it real quick, put it up here, where something strikes your forearm with that pole. Also, you can ram the person if you have a chance. You know, I was told that this doesn't feel good on your shins. Is that right?
Yep.
That shadow for everyone that knows who he is. One of these days he'll be on camera. Well, he's on the vlogs, so you guys should check out that. Okay, next we will be discussing a different type of chair as soon as I go get it. So we'll be back. We got a different chair. This chair is a everyday chair. It's not a sports chair. It's for everyday use, non-sport use. And how are you going to use this as a weapon? These, look at these different arms. They don't have the J arms, they're called. This, you have to strike, strike, strike. These ones also have removable leg rest. Get your opponent trapped in the corner, or you want to before, see in common, strike, jab, and block. And that's another way that you could use this kind of chair to defend yourself if you don't have any other options. Next, we'll be talking about Loft and crutches, forearm crutches. Defense on crutches. What you want to do, your main goal, you have a 3-foot pole. Jab. Jab in the face, throat, midsection. You can also upward block, downward block. Please have a club like this. So elbow, you can also block. Could also like that, because you got all this shaft, elbow with that part. Double jab, groin strike, shin strike. We thank you for watching. Subscribe down below. If you guys like this video, check it out. You guys can share it, put it on your own page. That'd be awesome. And let us know what you think. TripTaido@gmail.com. That's our email if you have any questions. And our new contest is February and March. We're gonna have the new TripTaido fan page membership. You name the group, you name the nickname for the members, you get a free membership. Send your ideas and your suggestions to TripTaido@gmail.com.
Also, YouTube now has a new layout and a few things might have got changed. So you want to make sure that you're receiving all the updates from us if you are subscribed to us on YouTube. If you're not, please go do. Under our name, TripTaido on YouTube, make sure there's a little button that'll say receive updates. Please click that, otherwise you're not receiving updates from us when we upload videos.
I did not know that.
Very important to do so, otherwise, well, we might not be getting our updates.
Yeah, that's why he's out here, and he didn't tell me to say that.
I forgot.
Okay, you guys rock. TripTaido fans rock. See you maybe February on a live episode for a event that is taking place in February. It's not confirmed, but I'm going to see if that could happen. Subscribe, share, up or down. I don't know where it is now.
Down. They moved that to. They change everything so much anymore. It changes everything around. Thank you. Have a good weekend.
Yep.